Dear friends, this is episode number 15. We have completed up to rule 43A in the previous episode. Now we have to see rule 44 of order 21. Rule 44, attachment of agricultural produce. Now please see why separate provision is made, because rule 43 says where property to be attached is movable property other than agricultural produce. Rule 43 we have already dealt with, in which agricultural produce is not covered. So there is a separate provision for agricultural produce, that is rule 44 and rule 45. Rule 44 says that where the property to be attached is agricultural produce, the attachment shall be made by affixing a copy of the warrant of attachment, where such produce is a growing crop on the land on which such crop is grown, or where such produce has been cut or gathered on the threshing floor or place of treading out grain, or like or fodder stack, or on which or in which it is deposited, and another copy of the outer door, etc., which is the outer door of the house in which the judgmentor ordinarily resides or carries on business or personally works for gain, last resided, etc., and the produce shall thereupon be deemed to have passed into the possession of the court by affixing this copy at the places mentioned in Rule 44. The result is that the produce shall thereupon be deemed to have passed into the possession of the court. It is not in the actual possession of the court, but it shall be deemed to be in the possession of the court. Rule 45, provisions as to agricultural produce under attachment. Where agricultural produce is attached, the court shall make such arrangements for the custody thereof as it may deem sufficient, and for purpose of enabling court to make such arrangements, every application for attachment of a growing crop shall specify the time at which it is likely to be fit to be cut or gathered, and the applicant shall deposit in court within a date to be fixed by the court such sum as the court may deem sufficient to defray the cost of watching and tending the crop till such time. So the expenses are to be deposited for the purpose of watching and protecting the crop. Subject to such conditions as may be imposed by the court, either in the order of attachment or in any subsequent order, the judgmentor may tend, cut, gather and store the produce, and do any other act necessary for nurturing or preserving it. That is, instead of the court making arrangements, the judgmentor himself may do it. That is, subject to such conditions as may be imposed by the court. And if the judgmentor fails to do all or any of the said acts, the decree holder may, with the permission of the court and subject to like conditions, do all such things necessary. And the cost incurred by the decree holder shall be recoverable from the judgmentor as if it were included in the decree. Now, what is of utmost importance is attachment of agricultural produce. It must be beforehand. That is, sufficient time must be there. There is a provision, subrule 5. A growing crop which from its very nature does not admit of being stored shall not be attached under this rule at any time less than 20 days before the time at which it is likely to be fit to be cut or gathered. So sufficient time must be there for the purpose of attaching such agricultural produce. So before harvest, see, if it is a it does not admit of being stored at least 20 days before the harvest, it must be the necessary application should be filed before court so that the court can make such arrangements as are necessary. So these are the provisions. Then subrule 3 of rule 45, an agricultural produce attached or a growing crop shall not be deemed to have ceased to be under attachment or to require attachment merely because it has been severed from the soil. It is not necessary. Even if it is severed from the soil, it can be subject to attachment. Then subrule 4, where an order of attachment of growing crop has been made at a considerable time before the crop is likely to be fit to be cut or gathered, the court may suspend the execution of the order for such time as it thinks fit, and may in its discretion make a further order prohibiting removal of the crop pending the execution of the order of attachment. That power is also given to the court. Suspend the execution of the order. Order is passed for attachment. Suspend it for the purpose of so that the crop can be at the proper time be attached. But further order prohibiting removal of the crop. See, the order of attachment is suspended, but it must be protected from dealing with, from being dealt with by the judgmentor or somebody. Some contumacious conduct on his part may result in the attachment having not its full effect, full vigor, and the attachment may fail. Therefore, sufficient steps should be taken by the court while suspending the order, prohibiting the judgmentor from removing the crop. Then subrule 5, I read that sufficiently early, 20 days at least, must be there. So this is one scheme, that is rule 42 to 45. 42 to 45. Movable property, attachment. One group, one section says movable property other than agricultural produce. Then two provisions, rule 44 and 45, exclusively for agricultural produce. The different situations to be dealt with, different situations which may arise in the process of, in the application, in the order, in the process, and in the execution of that order are dealt with in these rules. Rule 41, which I said earlier, it's a separate one. All come under the heading attachment of property. Up to rule 57, it come under the heading attachment of property. Here, rule 41 is really not attachment, but it is still, because it is to be attached, and therefore a property to be attached and sold, therefore it is included there. And under rule 41, that is, it has been held in 2009 4 KLT 683. I forgot to mention while dealing with the rule 41. Under rule 41, this decision 2009 4 KLT 683, which is this rule 41 is not limited to attachment alone. It applies to personal execution as well. That is, requiring the judgmentor to disclose by affidavit, by examination also, all these details can be gathered. That does not apply to attachment alone. It applies to personal execution as well. Though it comes under the heading attachment of property, going by this decision, this rule 41 can be applied. I should have said it while dealing with the rule 41, but I forgot to mention it. So even though it comes under the heading attachment of property, Rule 41 applies to arrest and detention as well. Please bear in mind that it is a provision which can be made use of wherever it is necessary to prove that he has means. Of course, if it is disclosed that some property is there, it is disclosed by affidavit or by the examination of the judgment debtor, that property can be proceeded with and the property can be attached and sold. That is a different thing. But at the same time, this process, going by the decision which I mentioned, 2009 4KLT 683, this can be used for not only when there is an attachment, but applies to personal execution as well. Now the next provision is, important provision is, Rule 46 to 46I. Rule 46 to 46I. There it is garnishee proceedings. To some extent complicated. I will deal with garnishee proceedings only after dealing with something which I said in episode number 12 and later which was pointed out to me that there is some other decision also. While dealing with section 60, I referred to a decision by Justice M. N. Krishnan. That is, you remember that were the salary to be attached, after attachment for 24 months, there must be a gap of 12 months. And thereafter the attachment can be continued. But it is also provided therein, where the attachment has been made in execution of one and the same decree, after the attachment has been effected for a period of 24 months, such portion shall be finally exempt from attachment in execution of that decree. Now, I also referred to 2018 1KLT 150, where there is an upward, there is a hike in the salary. That also can be subject of attachment of salary. Please read 2018 1KLT 150 also. Later, the correctness of the decision in 2007 4KLT 692 was challenged in some other case, and it was referred to a division bench. That was decided in 2019 3KHC 244. Equivalent citation 2019 3KHC 244, in which 2007 4KLT 692 was held not good law. What is referred to is in the 2019 decision, 2007 4KLT as such is not mentioned, but the case is mentioned, Sushila versus Inashu. There, Sushila versus Inashu, the corresponding citation in KHC is referred to in 2019 3KLT. There, the citation is 2007 3KHC 980. So that is equivalent to 2007 4KLT 692. That was held not good law. What is the point decided? What is such portion of the salary was decided there? In fact, from reading that division bench judgment, the facts are not very clear. Now, in fact, this was pointed out by a lawyer in Palakkad, that why I did not refer to that. Of course, that did not come to my mind. I did not remember that decision when I made this, that episode number 12. I am sorry for it. And I should have mentioned it, but I did not mention. But going through 2019 3KHC 244, that is, the name of the case is Shreeja versus P.G. Sharma. Shreeja versus P.G. Sharma. In that judgment, it is not very clear in what circumstances such contention was raised. Therefore, I leave it at that. But I remember several years ago onwards, when I was a lawyer, I was attending the academy and taking classes to the judicial officers. At that time, I remember Mr. Achyudanunni was the director. Even at that time, while dealing with execution, I used to mention under clause 5, attachment clause I, attachment of salary, that I have got a different interpretation. And Mr. Achyudanunni was not in agreement with that. And when two CRPs, before when I was a lawyer, I filed two CRPs when I raised this point. What is such portion? But I do not know. Thereafter, I became a judge. I do not know what happened. I did not see anything reported there. Therefore, that point was not decided. Sometimes the cases may go settled or something like that. Nobody knows. Now, this point was not seen decided there. The point which I raised was that even if it is one and the same decree, even after the attachment continued for a period of 24 months, it can be again attached. It can be subjected to again attachment. Not such portion, but a different portion. And that process can be continued till the amount becomes zero. I will give an example. I borrowed 10 lakhs from you. I am a salaried person. I did not repay the amount. You sought to attach my salary. Take it that my salary is 25,000. First 1,000 rupees and 2/3 of the remainder are exempt. So, after deducting 1,000, it is 24,000, then 2/3 minus again 16,000, the attachable portion is 8,000. By attaching that amount for 24 months, 10 lakhs will not be realized. And if it is to be interpreted that after 24 months continuous attachment, of this attachable portion, it cannot be further attached. If that contention is if that interpretation is accepted, what will be your position? You cannot realize the full amount under the decree. Same person, that is yourself, lent 10 lakhs to 10 persons, 1 lakh each. Whatever may be their salary. They are all salaried people. They may be having 5,000, 6,000, 8,000, 10,000, like that salary. You attach their salary. 24 months each. Then a gap of 12 months. Then again it can be attached. Continuous, again 24 months. Then gap 12 months. Again it can be attached. Till the last pie is recovered. What is the logic for such an interpretation? This was my view even before when I was a young lawyer. And I raised that point in one case. I do not know what happened. See, a person lends money to 10 people. All salaried people. The whole amount can be recovered from them after 24 months then 12 months gap, 24 months, 12 months gap, 24 months, like that. Suppose you have lent that money to one person, namely me, you cannot recover the whole thing. What is the logic? I could not find any logic. I could not find any decision also on that point. Now, unfortunately, this 2007 4KLT 692 or 2018 1KLT 150 or the latest decision 2019 3KHC 244 does not deal with this question. Therefore, I would interpret like this. Don't take it as correct. This is only a view by a person. No authoritative pronouncement on it. Let us take it that 25,000 is the salary of a person. What is the attachable portion? 8,000. That was attached for 24 months. Then, what is such portion? Such portion is 8,000. Such portion mentioned in section 60I proviso. We will go through it again. Provided that were any part of such portion of the salary, what is such portion? First 1,000 rupees and 2/3 of the remainder. Has been under attachment, whether continuously or intermittently, for a total period of 24 months. Such portion shall be exempt from attachment until the expiry of a further period of 12 months. And where such attachment has been made in execution of one and the same decree, shall, after the attachment has continued for a total period of 24 months, be finally exempt from attachment. Two interpretations are possible. One interpretation is, such portion means the portion of the salary after deducting the first 1,000 rupees and 2/3 of the remainder. That is such amount. Now, that if that interpretation is taken, what is under attachment? 8,000 rupees. Now, deduct from 25,000, 1,000 which is the permanent exemption, plus 8,000. That means 9,000. From 25,000, at 9,000. So, after deducting 9,000, what will be the balance? 16,000. 2/3 of it also deduct. Then you will get a figure that will be less than 8,000 rupees. Attach it for 24 months. Then upload it. Add on that amount also. Suppose we take that it is 6,500. That exact calculation we have to make. So, first 1,000 and 2/3 of the remainder, 25,000 salary, first 1,000, 2/3 of the remainder is 16,000, 16 plus 1. After 24 months, 12 months gap. Then, you can again attach, is my personal view. Then, how the calculation or computation is to be made? 25,000? First 1,000, then the attachment already affected 8,000, total 9,000, the balance is 16,000, deduct 2/3 of it from that amount, then you will get a figure, attach it for 24 months. Then next time, let us take it that it is 6,500 for the purpose of this episode. It is not the exact amount. So next time, what is to be excluded? First 1,000, 8,000, plus this 6,500. Total it. Deduct from 25,000. Then you will get a figure. Again, deduct 2/3 of the same. Then you will get a figure. That will be somewhere around between 4,000 and 5,000. You can attach it for 24 months. then again this deduct such portion which has been attached. So if the interpretation is to be taken as such portion being the amount under attachment, then there is some logic in it. What is the logic? A person lending money to 10 persons, 1 lakh each, all salaried men, people, salaried men, then the whole amount can be recovered from their salary after following this clause I. 24 months, then gap of 12 months, then again 24 months, until it becomes the decree amount is fully satisfied. Whereas if the lending is to a single person, after execution, attachment of salary for 24 months, the decree holder has to forget about attachment. What is the logic in it? Same 10 lakhs given as a loan to 10 persons and as a loan to one person. If it is given to one person, then you cannot recover full. If it is to 10 persons, you can recover the full amount. There is not logic in it. In fact, this point I never wanted to mention in this lecture series, because we need not go to such complications at this stage. That may be for lawyers and judges, it may be necessary, not for students. Therefore, since I thought that this is only intended for students, I deliberately did not raise that point. Therefore, but since a lawyer pointed out that I omitted this, so I have to mention that. I mentioned it. Then while mentioning, I think that it is my duty, or rather privilege, to say this thought which occurred to me at least 25 years ago and which I was saying all throughout in the Judicial Academy, but not to the acceptance of the successive directors. No court has decided that point. Therefore, if somebody wants to raise such a point, please raise it. And if some court is inclined to decide it, let it be decided. The point, I think it is clear. Point is clear. That is, again I will say, 25,000, first 1,000, two-third of the remainder, you will get 8,000, attached for 24 months. Then next time, first 1,000 plus 8,000, 9,000. Deduct it from that amount from salary, 25,000. So minus 9,000, it is 16,000. Deduct again two-thirds of that 16,000. Remainder, what is remainder? Remainder is what is left out. So the expression remainder, salary to the extent of first 1,000 rupees and two-thirds of the salary, is not the expression used. Two-thirds of the remainder. Remainder need not necessarily be after deducting 1,000 rupees. If such portion is under attachment, it is permanently, finally exempt from attachment. What is finally exempt from attachment, if we read that clause, is such portion. So reading clause I along with the proviso, two limbs of the proviso together, and taking into account the fact that there is no logic in the example which I have given, exempting, that is, helping a decree holder who has lent money to 10 persons, and punishing a decree holder who has lent money to a single person. Single person who has received 10 lakhs may be in a better position than the persons who borrowed 1 lakh each. So it is bereft of any logic. So if that is to be accepted, and if this interpretation is accepted, there is logic. Because you cannot deprive a single person of his salary throughout. Give some benefit. That benefit is exempt that 8,000, then exempt again that next attachment. Then you will get ultimately, after the considerable period is over, this attachable portion becomes zero. Stop it there. Why not we consider such an interpretation? It is for you to think, it is for the lawyers to think, it is for the law students to think. I have mentioned in the nuance in the previous batches also. This time I thought that I need not trouble you with all these complicated areas. Therefore, I did not mention in episode number 12. Now, I am driven to that because of this omission on my part to mention 2019 3KHC 244. Now, we will deal with, it's a very important provision, garnishee proceedings, 46 to 46I. Very important, to some extent difficult also. So, next episode, we will deal with it. But you must have a CPC with you. I will say some markings should be made and you have to mark it then. Then it will be very easy to understand. Thank you. We'll see in the next episode.